Hello students, welcome to my channel Maths Club. I am Professor Deepanjan Kumar De. Today we are going to study on chromatic polynomial. Already I have discussed what is chromatic polynomial. Now today we have to find the chromatic polynomial for the disconnected graph. That is when the graph is not connected, then how to find chromatic polynomial, disconnected graph. Of disconnected means the graph has two or three or more than one components are there, then how to find the chromatic polynomial. Okay, how to find the chromatic polynomial. This is very important topic for BTech exam, BC exam, MC exam, MSc mathematics, and this also important for GATE and NET exam. So this I have taken a property of chromatic polynomial, connected property. That means here just you have to follow this property for the graph G which are not connected, that is disconnected, or you can say components of graph, then the chromatic polynomial of G is E G lambda, that is G is the graph, lambda is the chromatic polynomial, lambda we have to find the lambda is the chromatic actually polynomial. Pg lambda equal to Pg1 lambda into Pg2 lambda into Pg lambda, Pg3 lambda, dot, Pgm lambda. Where G1, G2 and dot, Gm are connected components of graph G. Okay. So then the chromatic polynomial of G is Pg1 lambda into Pg2 lambda into Pg3 lambda, dot, Pgm, Gm lambda. Okay. So I have taken a sum here. Find the chromatic polynomial and also find the chromatic number from the graph G. But G equal to this graph. So this graph. Okay. How to find the chromatic polynomial and chromatic number? This graph. You see the solution is here. I'm just writing here. Solution. The given graph is disconnected and has two components G1 and G2. Two components. This graph has two components G1 and G2. What is G1? G1 you can say G1 equal to a tree. This is a tree of four vertices. Vertices. G, tree of four vertices. And G2, G2 equal to, G2 equal to a complete graph, a complete graph with three vertices, that is K3. Okay, K3. Therefore, the chromatic polynomial, chromatic polynomial of G is denoted by Pg lambda is equal to two components G1 and G2. This is G2. Okay, G1 and G2. So we can say Pg1 lambda into Pg2 lambda. Okay. So now what is Pg1 lambda? Now this is equation 1, I can say. This is equation 1. What is Pg1 lambda? Now we have to find what is Pg1 lambda. Pg1 is a tree. Then that chromatic polynomial of Pg1 equal to lambda into lambda minus 1 n minus 1. This, because G is a tree, so chromatic polynomial of, this is the formula, chromatic polynomial of a tree for n vertices. So if this graph has three vertices, so n value is 3. N value is n equal to 3, I am just putting, because it is a tree having 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm sorry. It is a graph having not 3, having 4 vertices. Okay, not 3, 4 vertices. A tree with 4 vertices. So n equal to 4. Now just putting lambda into lambda minus 1 to the power 4 minus 1. That is lambda into lambda minus 1 to the power 3. So this is the chromatic polynomial for Pg1. Now quadratic polynomial of Pg2, that is lambda, is equal to, this is a complete graph having three vertices. G2 is a complete graph having three vertices. So formula is lambda into lambda minus 1 into lambda minus 2 ... lambda minus n plus 1. So n value is 3, so we have to take n value is 3, so minus 3 plus 2 minus 3 plus 2. Be careful here, n value is 3, minus 3 plus 2, that is lambda minus 2. So up to this we have to take lambda into lambda minus 1 into lambda minus 2. So this is the chromatic polynomial for graph G2. Okay. Therefore, chromatic polynomial of Pg lambda, that is equation 1 becomes. Equation 1 becomes. Pg1, just putting the value of Pg1 lambda and Pg2 lambda in equation 1. So therefore this becomes Pg lambda is equal to this Pg lambda 1, Pg1 lambda is lambda into lambda minus 1 to the power 3, and lambda into Pg2 lambda into lambda minus 1 into lambda minus 2. Okay, this becomes lambda square into lambda minus 1 4 to the power 4 into lambda minus 2. This is the chromatic polynomial for this graph G. Okay. So now if we put the value of lambda equal to 1. Suppose lambda equal to 1, I am putting lambda equal to 1. Lambda equal to 1, I am putting here. So, if I put, that is Pg1. That is lambda equal to 1 over here. If we put, that is this becomes 0. That Pg2, this becomes 0. That is lambda value is 2. This becomes 0. And when that Pg3, this equal to, that is 3 square into 3 minus 1 to the power 4 into 3 minus 2. So that means 9 into 2 to the power 4, that is 16 into 1. So this not equal to 0. That means the value of lambda is 3. So chromatic polynomial of Pg3 not equal to 0. Therefore, the chromatic number of graph G is equal to 3. Note that if we put lambda equal to 4, lambda equal to 4, this also, then Pg lambda 4 is not equal to 0. But 4 is not the chromatic number, because we have to see the minimum value of lambda such that Pg lambda not equal to 0. So it is 3, lambda Pg 3 not equal to 0, so the chromatic polynomial number is 3 for this graph. Okay, this is the easiest method I explain here. So don't forget to, if you like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and subscribe button and the bell. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, on.